Hello, I'm Samhita with my teammate Anurag and Rishita. Present the paper, the Vickery auction with single duplicate bidder approximates the optimal revenue. These days, auctions are widely employed at every level of modern economy, from an individual selling an item on eBay to allocation of coal blocks. The purpose of these auctions is to generate more money for the seller. A lot of work in the mechanism design has been done to achieve the optimal revenue. The revenue optimal auctions are player dependent mechanisms where the revenue of the auctioneer is maximized with the allocation rule based on the player distributions of the bidders. These auctions are complicated and has an NP-hard complexity. As they are prior dependent, they always need some information about the prior. However, in BCG auction, there is no consideration of prior information, and these are allocative efficient. In this paper, we see that VCG auctions can approximate the optimal auctions by incorporating additional information from their prior distributions. Now, let us look at Meyerson's characterization of optimal auctions. In mechanisms like VCG and CLASS, reporting truth is a weakly dominant strategy. That is, there can exist non-truthful strategies in equilibrium. In the case where players have different player distribution, some players can bid lower than their actual valuation and still have it as a dominant strategy. So Meyerson came up with a BIC mechanism that maximizes the revenue in expectation of a distribution by introducing virtual valuations. Here, every bidder's value is replaced by the virtual valuation, which is the valuation in frame of reference of bidder. In this setting, bidder with the highest virtual valuation wins the auction, and the payment is uniquely determined for this allocation rule. Expected revenue is calculated as the sum of all the bidders over possible valuation. Now we speak about revenue curve. As mentioned in the paper, consider a setting where bidder B is drawn from a distribution F. For every price B, bidder B will buy the item with a probability 1 minus f of P. The quantile of P is defined as the probability of selling an item at a price P. This function is decreasing with P. The revenue curve is assumed to be a concave function where it increases up to a true valuation of bidder B and then decreases. Consider that bidders are drawn from a uniform distribution 0, 1. Then the revenue of Q is defined as Q into 1 minus Q, and the revenue curve will be as shown in the slide. For each quantile Q, the valuation V of Q is equal to S inverse of 1 minus Q. It is a decreasing function with respect to Q. The derivative of revenue at Q is called the virtual value of V of Q. Ex ante optimal revenue. Given regular distributions with revenue curves R1 to Rn, ex ante optimal revenue tries to maximize the sum of the revenues from each bidder. This ex ante revenue is strictly stronger than optimal revenue.
Now that we have a notion of an optimal auction, as given by Meyerson, the question arises, why don't we always use an optimal auction? One reason is that it has a very high complexity in terms of computation. Another reason is that it also requires us to have some prior information about the bidders. VCG auction, on the other hand, is simple and prior free. It also yields the efficient allocation. An interesting result stated by Bulo and Klemperer says that by adding a single duplicate bidder to a VCG auction, you can extract a higher revenue than the optimal auction without that bidder. However, the issue with this theorem is that all the n bidders require to have come from the same probability distribution. If we relax this constraint, as shown by Hartline and Ruff Garden, we can have n bidders coming from n distinct probability distributions. And if we add one duplicate from each of these distributions, then the revenue we'll get will be at least half the optimal value. The main result of this paper is to relax Bulow and Klemperer's theorem to the more general setting of Hartland and Rough Garden, that is, the n bidders can draw from n different probability distributions with some constant loss of optimality. So, the main result of this paper shows that in a single item auction with n bidder whose values are drawn independently from n distribution, we would be able to find one bidder upon duplicating whom we will be able to get some constant fraction of the optimal revenue. So, now I will show the intuition behind the proof of this result. First, we will derive some loser bounds of 1 by 40 of the optimal revenue, and then we will parameterize this to optimize over the parameters and get the desired bound of 1 by 10th of the optimal revenue. Like most of the proofs in the paper, we divide the proof into two parts. Case number 1, where there exists a high valuation bidder. A high valuation bidder is one that bids more than half of the optimal price with a probability greater than 1 by 4. X ante revenue in this case will be half of the optimal revenue into the probability that the bidder bids more than half of the optimal revenue, which is 1 by 4. Now, according to Bulow and Klemperer, if we duplicate the bidder I from the probability distribution of the high valuation bidder, then with a VCG auction, we will be able to get at least more than this X ante revenue. Therefore, a VCG auction with a single duplicate bidder in this case will give revenue greater than or equal to 1 by 8th of the optimal revenue. Now, case number 2, where there is no such bidder, which means for all I, we have their 1 by 4th quantile less than or equal to half of the optimal price. Now, let us consider set S for which the valuation at the optimal quantiles is more than half of the optimal one. Where Qi tilde is the optimal solution. Now, summation of I not belonging to S, the revenue of the ith bidder will be less than half of the optimal value into summation of quantiles. Now, since we know the total summation of quantiles is less than 1, now we know that the optimal revenue is nothing but the sum of revenue curves of every player. And we can split this summation into two parts for players in S and players not in S. Now, as shown above, we know that the summation for players not in S is less than OPT by 2. Then, the value of the summation for players in S is more than half of the OPT value. Therefore, we can say that the summation for players in S is more than half of the optimal. Now, we'll define Qi dash as the quantile that gets us half of the optimal value. Now, since the quantile is a decreasing function, the quantile will be more than the optimal quantile but less than 1 by 4. From the concavity of the revenue curves, we have that the revenue at quantile Qi dash will be more than 3/4 of the revenue at the optimal quantile. Now, the summation of revenues at the quantiles Qi dash is at least 3/4 of the revenues at the optimal quantiles. And since we know that the summation of revenue at the optimal quantile is at least half of the optimal revenue. Then for the bidders in S, the summation of revenue at the QI dash quantile is at least 3 by AS of the optimal revenue. Therefore, we get summation of quantiles for the bidders in S is at least 3 by 4. The probability of the event that at least two bidders bid more than half of the optimum price is the complement of the event that either at least one bidder bids more than half of the optimal price or no bidder bids more than half of the optimal price. For the case where no bidder bids more than half of the optimal price is the intersection of the events that each bidder does not bid more than half of the optimal price. Now, using Bernoulli's inequality, we can show that this is less than e to the power minus 3 by 4. For the second case, where probability of one bidder bidding more than half of the optimal price is that one bidder bids more than half of the optimal price and the rest of the others do not bid more than half of the optimal price. Now again, using Bernoulli's inequality, we can show that the probability of this event is also less than e raised to power minus 3 by 4. Therefore, probability of two bidders bidding more than half of the optimal price is 1 minus 2 into e raised to power minus 3 by 4, which is more than 1 by 20. Therefore, in this case, the expected ex ante revenue is nothing but half of the optimal price into the probability, that is 1 by 20 equal to 1 by 40 of the optimal price. Now that we have derived a loser bound of 1 by 40th of the optimal revenue, we could parameterize the previous proof by replacing half of the optimal value with alpha times the optimal value and 1/4 quantile with beta, and then when we optimize over alpha and beta, we get the desired bound of 0.108 of the optimal value. Now that we have shown that picking a single bidder to duplicate will yield us a constant fraction of the optimal revenue, the question that naturally arises is which bidder should we pick? Now, we cannot just pick a bidder randomly because it can be shown that we will not be able to get constant fraction of the optimal revenue in that case. According to theorem 3.4, we have some minimal and resilient requirements for choosing the bidder to duplicate. The authors present three different cases. Consider case 1, where the auctioneer has access to the value of the revenue curves at some quantile beta for every bidder. Then he can duplicate the bidder that maximizes the value of the revenue curve at that point. If this is not the case, then suppose the auctioneer has access to some oracle which provides an approximation to the revenue curve. In that case also, he can select a bidder according to the rule given by the theorem. Now, in the worst case, if he does not have access to any of these, then he can simply draw a sample Si independently from each distribution, and then select the maximum sample. Now, whichever distribution that gave the sample, he can duplicate the bidder from that and still be able to get a good fraction of the optimal revenue. Now, the results shown in section 3 for VCG auctions with one item can be extended and generalized to VCG auction with k items. Now, this happens in two settings. In theorem 4.1, we consider the setting where we have k additional bidders drawn from the probability distribution of any of the n original bidders. In other setting, that of Heartland and Rough Gardens, in theorem 4.2, we have k extra bidders, at least one of whom can win, at most one of whom can win the object. That is, both the bidder and the duplicate cannot take the object. Now that we have shown that there are some ways of duplicating bidders that yield at least a constant fraction of the optimal revenue, and there are multiple possible ways to duplicate the bidder, what is the best revenue you can get? Is there some upper bound to this revenue? Now, using a novel technique devised by the authors, using look-ahead auctions, they have shown that for an auction with two bidders, which are drawn independently from two regular distributions, then we can get at least 3/4 of the optimal revenue with an auction with four bidders, one bidder duplicated from each of these distributions.
This paper presents the following new results. What is the revenue which we get if we add one duplicate bidder, and which distribution should we duplicate? The main contribution of this paper is that it manages to provide a bound for single duplicate in a more general setting than that of Bulow and Klempner. The authors have also formulated Heartland and Rough Gardens result for n equal to 2 players and given a tighter bound of 3/4, which is obviously better than the original bound of half. However, for n greater than 2, we need more advanced techniques. So, in the end, this paper has formulated over the results which were given by the scientists Bulow and Klempner and Heartland and Rough Gardens. Thank you.